This is Nasha Kasha, Ukrainian Almanac. 28 minutes of stories for everyone about Ukrainian life. My name is Stefan Andrusiak. Vitaю. Welcome.
This episode is from our archives. It was last heard December 2018.
In the weeks before Christmas, in that land, Toronto, there was once upon a time a parade, don't you know? With 22 bands and 25 floats, and on the last of the floats was Saint Nick. Ho, ho, ho.
Ho, 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 ho. Merry Christmas. Ho, 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 ho.
The first Europeans to arrive in the New World brought St. Nicholas with them. Vikings dedicated a cathedral to him in Greenland. On his first voyage, Columbus named a Haitian port for St. Nicholas in 1492. But after 1517, the Protestant Reformation, particularly in England, downgraded the idea of sainthood. Still, Germanic and East European cultures maintained their love for St. Nicholas. Klaus was short for Niklaus, and in 1821, Klaus became Claus. That's because in 1821, there came the publication of the very first lithographed book to America. It was called The Children's Friend, and this Santa Claus arrived from the north in a sleigh pulled by a reindeer. The anonymous poem and the illustrations proved pivotal in shifting imagery away from a saintly bishop. Santa Claus rewarded good behavior, leaving gifts, a doll, a ball. The jolly elf image received another big boost in 1823. It was a poem titled A Visit from St. Nicholas, now better known as The Night Before Christmas. After 1915, Coca-Cola began featuring the jolly bearded man in its advertising. Department stores featured Santa Claus in parades. The Salvation Army conscripted him for their popular Red Kettle campaign for the poor at Christmas. It's an evolving image, a benevolent distortion, a shape that has shifted. For the better part of the next half hour, I'm going in search of St. Nicholas, or as Ukrainians know him, Святий Миколай. We'll start at the corner of Queen Street and Bellwoods Avenue in Toronto. It's the site of St. Nicholas Ukrainian Catholic Church. The St. Nicholas Ukrainian Catholic Church choir sang Psalm 102. The choir is directed by Zhanna Zinchenko.
Hi, I'm Father Alexander Laschuk, and I'm an assistant priest here at St. Nicholas Ukrainian Catholic Church in Toronto.
Okay, so this is the seat of Святий Миколай.
Yes, yeah. No, we're certainly, I think, one of the main St. Nicholas churches in Canada, so it's people know us from far and wide, yeah.
Okay, so can you give me a sense of who Святий Миколай is and what he means to people or should mean to people today?
Yeah, so St. Nicholas was a bishop in the 4th century in Myra, which is now in Asia Minor, part of Turkey now. And he was known for doing very generous acts. You know, he gave dowries to young ladies who would otherwise have been sold away by their parents, or helped those who were in need, ransomed prisoners. And so he was a very generous man who gave of himself to help other people.
Do you have any idea of where this idea of giving presents came from?
Well, I think just mimicking that idea that, you know, St. Nicholas would go and do those acts of charity at night when nobody saw. And so that would be that same kind of idea of seeing his generosity of helping others, and that we would do that generosity. I mean, obviously St. Nicholas did it to strangers, now we do it to our loved ones, but hopefully also this time of year we remember those who are without, and St. Nicholas was a good example for that.
Mm-hmm. Is this a tough area in Toronto?
Well, it's not as tough as it used to be, but you know, this part of town, CAMH, which is a large mental health hospital, is not far from here, so we have a lot of people in the area who struggle with addiction issues and different things like that, so it's a good reminder for us to help them. That the Scott Mission is not far away, which is one of the main men's shelters around, so there are still those people who are being left behind by gentrification, and we have that, I guess, calling to follow St. Nicholas's example. Come to St. Nicholas Parish, you know, this time of year, to remember those who are going without.
Okay.
Nasha Kasha comes to you from Radio Western 94.9 FM on the campus of Western University in London, Ontario, Canada. We're heard on CHMR 93.5 FM in St. John's, Newfoundland, on CKDU 88.1 FM in Halifax, on local 107.3 FM in St. John, New Brunswick, on CJAS Radio 93.5 FM in San Augustine, Quebec, on CJLO 1690 AM in Montreal, on CFRC 101.9 FM in Kingston, on CFMU 93.3 FM in Hamilton, on CKMS 102.7 FM in Kitchener-Waterloo, on CJAM 99.1 FM in Windsor and Detroit, on CKLU 96.7 FM in Sudbury, on CILU 102.7 FM in Thunder Bay, on 101.5 UMFM in Winnipeg, on CJTR 91.3 FM in Regina, on CFMQ 98.1 FM in Hudson Bay, Saskatchewan, on CFBX 92.5 FM in Kamloops, on CIVL 101.7 FM in Abbotsford, on CJSF 90.1 FM in Vancouver, and on CHLY 101.7 FM in Nanaimo, British Columbia. Who lives in Stratford, Ontario, wrote the book St. Nicholas, Bishop of Myra, The Life and Times of the Original Father Christmas. He had come to know a man, a widower in his hometown of Patara, who had lost his income and was considering selling his three daughters into slavery. Nicholas was appalled at the possibility. He placed an appreciable sum of gold in a cloth sack, crept to the man's house at night, and tossed the sack of coins into the window of the house. When the man awakened the next morning, he found the gold, thanked God, and provided his eldest daughter with a dowry. A few days later, Nicholas repeated the same act of generosity. When the man found another sum of gold, he praised God out loud and resolved to find the man to discover who had rescued him from poverty. After a few days had passed, Nicholas again threw a gift of gold into the house. The man heard the sound and arose to run after his benefactor, and reaching him began to thank him. Nicholas, however, pulled himself away, insisting that the man promise to keep the secret for the rest of his life. When famine raged in Lycia, Bishop Nicholas desperately sought grain to feed the starving people of his diocese. Grain ships put into harbor at Myra's sea depot at Andriaki during their voyage from Alexandria, Egypt, to Constantinople, which was the new capital of the Roman Empire. Bishop Nicholas met with the captains and entreated them to release part of their grain to feed the famine-stricken of Lycia. The captains refused at first, fearing that they would be held accountable in Constantinople for any loss of their cargo. Bishop Nicholas persevered, however, assuring the captains that they would not suffer any adverse judgment. He persuaded them to unload hundreds of measures of corn. Bishop Nicholas distributed the grain, which nourished the hungry of Lycia for 2 years, and provided them with seed to plant and to harvest. Tibikon states that he relies upon the stories of Saint Nicholas that Michael the Archimandrite of Constantinople collected. The Archimandrite published his bios of Saint Nicholas of Myra in Greek, possibly as early as the late 8th century. I'm going to tell you a story, and I'm going to read the original text, a letter, which was written in the Ukrainian language. But dear listeners, I will translate it in just a few minutes.
Тепер, дорогі слухачі, я вам прочитаю історію правдиву пана Адольфа Гладиловича. Це було 1961 році. Я тоді працював сортовельником листів у пошті у місті Лашін коло Монтреалу. Єдиний українець між кількадесятьма квебецькими французами. Одного грудинного дня, пізно ввечері, я побачив невеликий відкритий конверт. Він лежав окремо від других листів. На ньому не було поштової марки, а зате там прибито 4 штемплі. Чому аж 4? Зовсім просто. Адреса на конверті була написана по-українському, а адреси відправника взагалі не було. А що ніхто з тих, у чиєї руки попав той лист, не знав нашого письма, кожен тільки штемплював листа і не знав, що з ним далі робити. Щастя, що не викинули до скриньки на сміття. Видно, що листові судилося попасти у руки єдиного службовиця, який міг прочитати адресу. Я глянув на неї і очима своїми не вірив. Написано звичайним олівцем, вона була така. Небо до святого отця Миколая. Я витягнув з конверта листа, якого тут ніхто, крім мене, не був у силі прочитати. Це був лінійовний листок із шкільного зошита. Текст листа зайняв півтора сторінки листа. Між лініками було трохи невправно, але старенно і чітко виведні слова. Я читав їх із зворушенням. «Святий Отче Николаю, я називаюся Ігор Володимир Шульган. Я маю 6 років, я маю 3 сестри. Дарка, що має 7 років, Маруся, що має 1 рік, і Оксана, що має 9 років. Святий Отче Миколаю, як ви будете ходити, то прошу мені принесіть ковзалки сайз 12, шляфрок сайз 13 або 12 і полярис, і авто від Ігора Володимира Шульган». Прізвище дитини було мені відоме. Так називалася одна патріотична родина у місті Ласал, яке разом з другими довколішніми місцевостями обслуговувала Лашінська пошта. Я зараз заглянув у телефонічну книжку і легко знайшов телефон цієї родини. Було вже досить пізно, по 10:00. Усе ж таки, Я задзвонив. Відзивався приємний жіночий голос. Я перепросився, що так пізно дзвоню, і сказав, хто я є і яка справа. «Так-так, то наш син», – почув я в телефоні. Я прочитав до слухалки листа. «Дивіться», – дивувалася Ігорева мама. «А він нам нічого про листа не сказав і, видно, сам кинув його до скриньки. Бо він знав, що святий Миколай дасть йому те, про що він його просить у листі», – зауважив я. «Отак, тепер ми знаємо, що святий Миколай має йому дати. Дуже-дуже вам дякую», – раділа мати. «І хто тепер скаже, що святий Миколай не помагає тим, що в нього вірять і його люблять?» Та стаття появилася у часописі «Гомін України» 25 грудня 1998 року.
Спи, Ісусе, спи.
From her album «Іде звізда чудна», «There Comes a Wondrous Star», and the song «Sleep, Jesus, Sleep», «Спи, Ісусе, спи».
Zane Zelane was from the children's album «Усміхається сонечко, діти співають». Юрко Кулицький produced it. Vocal arrangements were by Віра Турко-Кулицький. The story prior to this song was about a postal worker of Ukrainian background who came across a letter. It was addressed in pencil without any postage on it at a postal sorting station in Lachine, Quebec. Lachine is a suburb of Montreal. Addressed in Ukrainian to Saint Nicholas, who resides in heaven. The six-year-old at the time was Ihor Shulhan. He did get his skates. I caught up with Ihor recently. Today, Ihor lives in Western Canada.
For those who grew up under the Soviet system, officially there was no Christmas, no St. Nicholas.
Back at St. Nicholas Ukrainian Catholic Church in Toronto, a handful of participants gather every week for a conversation about life, scriptures, church history, and some politics too. Anna Ugляр has been coming here for 15 years.
15 років, може більше. Бо я з нових іммігрантів, я приїхала.
And she still calls herself a new immigrant.
Ну і зразу пішла до церкви.
First thing she did was join the church.
Була маленькою, мене водили до церкви, і я, хоч у нас була заборонена церква в Союзі.
Чи святкували Святого Миколая у краю?
Ух, та, ну, не святкували вже, я в війну росла, то так, то ніхто не святкував Миколая в краю, ніхто не святкував вже. Як
тільки... Back then, church services were banned in Soviet Ukraine, but Anna and her family defied the prohibition.
Ми все в підпільні були, бо мій вуйко був священник.
Her uncle had spent 13 years in a monastery, but after the war, he was forcibly resettled.
І він... З українцями приїхав, він 13 років десь був в Перемишлі, в монастирі. Байрак він писався.
То гарно. Чи ви скучаєте за Україною?
О, певно, що скучаю. Я тут сама, бо дочка мала вже дитину, я приїхала, потім вже сідро вродила без мене. Я мала брата в Америці, я до нього приїхала, в нього була трошки, але тут... Мене запросила мого чоловіка тьоця. Дала мені запрошення, я приїхала.
Anna says she misses Ukraine. Still, she is happy to have been sponsored to immigrate to Canada by her husband's aunt.
Ви були бухгалтером на Україні?
Так. Цей самий Вуйко, мамин брат, що був священником. І він вже мав мешкання в 53-му році. Я приїхав, хтось мене взяв до Львова. І він каже, о, якийсь пан на госиді.
Her uncle, the ordained priest, had to practice his vocation in secret. It was he who encouraged Anna to find a profession, then personally guided her. An acquaintance had suggested accounting as a career. Her uncle led her by her hand to sign up at the appropriate school in Тернопіль.
На другий день рано Вуйко мене за руку і відвів до тої школи. Я вже мала свідоцтво, так ніби за всему клясу. За...
She had just finished grade 7. Thanks to her uncle's guidance and support, the accounting school enrolled her immediately. 2 years later, she went to work for a bank. Тернопіль, where she lived, was a manufacturing center with an emphasis on textiles.
Банки були у Совєтському Союзі?
Були, а як же? Були, мусили бути. Була Ощадний банк був, такий, що люди вкладали гроші.
I asked her if there were actually savings banks in the former Soviet Union. She says, of course there were, for personal accounts and special banks for the large factories.
Розрахунки мусили бути. Мусили, і на виробництво було, і, ну, і в нас в Тернополі, я сама в Тернополі прожила.
Тобі 32 роки працювала, так?
Так. Я прожила сама в Тернополі, то в нас були великі фабрики в Тернополі, де робили, спроваджували бавовну таку аж з Середньої Азії. І там...
In Tернопіль, she recalls, there were three thread factories employing 10,000 workers.
Там 10 тисяч працювало жінок. 10 тисяч, то дуже велике, то Союз побудував. То.
Чи ви хотіли сказати щось від вас про значення Святого Миколая і шанування Святого Миколая?
О, то звичайно, що це дуже для дітей, то дуже добре свято. І я от спиталася своїх внуків, кажу, чи ви слухаєте маму? Бо чоловік дочки помер, кажу, чи ви маму слухаєте? Бо вони вже дорослі, вже внукові 30 років і внуці. Кажу, бо тут Миколай питався, чи ви слушні, що може вам щось кине, яку сотку, дві тих доларів.
Колись...
Я маю лише, мені лишиться.
Колись то цукорки і поміранжі ставили під подушку, а тепер по сотками вики.
Так, а тепер я ще кажу, мені ще щось лишило сотка, то я вже би...
То називається інфляція.
Так, то я кажу, то вже ми будете мати подарки.
Щасливі, так?
Так.
То гарно. Щиро вам дякую, що ви зі мною.
Пані Анна worked for 32 years in that profession as a bookkeeper.
Ніколи не говорила до того.
You can hear the confidence in her voice when she speaks about those days.
Her uncle, taking her by the hand, had led her to school and into the relative security of a lifelong career.
Wherever you are this holiday season, I hope you search for and you find the spirit of Saint Nicholas.
I'd like to gratefully acknowledge that partial funding for Nasha Kasha is provided by the Shuchenko Foundation and by the Ukrainian Credit Union. Nasha Kasha is also a podcast. There's an easy way to access it for free. Go to nashakasha.libsyn.com. Nasha Kasha is one word. Libsyn is spelled LIBSYN.com. nashakasha.libsyn.com.
New Pathway Ukrainian News delivers news and insight every week in English and Ukrainian. Subscribe today at newpathway.ca.
You're listening to Carol of the Bells, originally composed by Mykola Leontovich in Ukraine 100 years ago. It was originally called Shchedrik, and it's performed here by the General Amherst Secondary School Choir, Amherstburg, Ontario.
To conclude, here is the Canadian Bandurist Capella. Their Christmas album is called Koleda, which is the Ukrainian word for Christmas carol. This one is about three wise men, conductors Andriy Dmitrovich and Pavlo Fondera.
Back in a week, God willing.
До милої зустрічі. За тиждень часу. Дорогі слухачі.